Hello, pen friends. In this video, I'm going to be trying something a little different than I normally do. Now, as my collection has grown, I've run into a couple of problems, one of which is it's hard for me to do reviews of pens where the only thing different is it's a different finish or a different material. So I don't necessarily want to go through a full-blown review, but I do want to show you the pen and give you a little bit of information about it. It could also be that it's a pen that's not really available for sale anymore, or that a review is kind of unnecessary or just duplicative, if that's even a word. Let's make up some words. So this is one, the pen in today's, we'll come up with a good name for these types of mini reviews or mini overviews, but the pen in this overview is a pen from the Japanese manufacturer Platinum. This is a Platinum 3776. Now, I've reviewed and talked ad nauseum about the 3776. It's a pen I like a lot. I've got two of them. I've got one in Chartreuse Blue and one in Burgoyne Red. And these are great workhorse pens. Platinum has some fantastic nibs. And so I'm always on the lookout for something new from Platinum. And one of my complaints with some of the Platinums are you don't use a lot of very interesting materials. But they do have a line of celluloid pens. One is a koi celluloid. You may have seen those floating around. It's kind of a red and white, looks almost like koi scales on a koi fish. This is the jade celluloid version. Now, y'all know me in green, and if you follow my Instagram account at instagram.com/penhabit, you'll know that I'm a huge gardener, and as soon as things start turning green in the spring, that's like when life suddenly improves for me, so because I love to be outside. I love growing flowers and vegetables and that sort of stuff. So anything that's green is something I can get behind. This is the jade celluloid version. Now, I will link in the cards and in the description below to the original review of the Platinum 3776s that I have done. I've done a couple of reviews. And so you'll be able to see those. I am going to call out the differences here. So in this particular case, I'll do the blue one as comparison. So one of the big differences between the celluloid versions of the Platinums and the regular versions of the Platinums are the regular versions are injection molded. You can't injection mold celluloid, at least not as far as I know. So any of the celluloid versions of these pens are turned on a lathe. That automatically makes them more labor intensive than injection molding. And the material itself is probably going to be more expensive as well, because celluloid needs to cure for at least a year usually. When the celluloid is poured, it needs to cure for a year, and then it needs to cure after you drill it because you're bringing new oils to the surface and that sort of thing. So these pens are going to be more expensive. They're also a little bit narrower and a little bit shorter. The band, you don't have the double band here. You've only got a single band. Yellow gold, really nice material. This jade celluloid is beautiful, I think. The other difference on this pen is that this pen comes with a soft, fine nib. Now, the jade celluloid version of the pen does not come with a soft, fine nib. I have a relationship with the person from whom I bought it, or the retailer from whom I bought it, and I said, hey, I know that Platinum makes soft, fine nibs. Is there any chance I could get a soft, fine nib to put on this pen? And they said, sure, I'll swap one from another pen. You may not be able to do that, but I'd like to show you the Platinum soft, fine nibs anyway, because they're a really interesting nib and one that I actually tend to like quite a bit. Aside from that, pretty much everything else is the same. It's, you know, the same grip section, the same nib shape, the same feed, the same proprietary converters. So it's a really nice pen. And Platinum has some of the best nibmeisters in the business, in my opinion. Their nibs are almost always perfectly adjusted. As I've mentioned many times in the past, their nibs are adjusted and polished more toward the toothy side. So if you like a butter smooth nib, this might not be the right option unless you're willing to polish the nib. So keep that in mind. All right, so a bit of writing here, and I'm going to do a little bit of flex writing, quote unquote flex writing, just to show you how the soft fine nib, how the line variation is on the soft fine nib. So this needs to get the ink flow going. There you go. And the ink in this is Rohrer and Klingner Alt Goldgrün, I believe, actually. You know, it's too bad someone doesn't make booklets in which you can track what inks you have inked up. Just verify that I've got the ink in here that I think I do. Yay, I was right. Alt Goldgrün. I inked this up like a month and a half ago and haven't checked it for a long time. Goldgrün. So, as I will often say, this is not a flex nib. Don't expect to get tons of line variations. You can see you can get a little bit of line variation out of this soft fine nib, but you're not going to get like a lot. The platinum soft fine nibs, first of all, the platinum's nibs run a good full size to a size and a half narrower than their Western counterparts. So this is a very fine, fine nib, a very fine, fine nib. This is even finer than most Western extra fines. You know, Platinum is the company that has the ultra extra fine. They like to go real tiny on the nib tips. So just be aware of that if you want to buy this. It's going to be a much finer nib than you probably expect, but it has a wonderful bouncy cushion to the nib. This is a fun nib to write with. It is pretty toothy, like a 3.5, maybe a 4 on the feedback scale. Like pencil, like a hard leaded pencil. You know, kind of, I'm not a pencil person. I know there are a lot of pencil people out there who go nuts over pencils. So I can't give you like the exact designation of a hard pencil, but one of the hard pencils that's going to be pretty light. That's kind of the feel it has to it. Solid ink flow, you know, Platinum's nibs, I always almost say Pelican, Platinum's nibs are always almost perfectly adjusted. Doesn't work real well in reverse writing. It's pretty, it's really scratchy. Ugh, gross. No thanks. Not that I ever do reverse writing when I'm not outside of these reviews. But yeah, I like this a lot. I've used it a lot. This soft fine nib, if I buy any more Platinums, I'm pretty sure I'm going to buy them with the softer nibs. I like softer nibs, and I've mentioned that earlier. The regular Platinum nibs are quite rigid. So if you like a rigid nib, and I know a lot of people do, you can get it with just the regular ultra extra fine, fine, medium, broad nibs. I believe there's a music nib. I don't know if some of those specialty nibs are available on this particular version of the pen. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the Jade, any of the celluloid pens are going to run quite a bit more for a variety of reasons. There are not as many of them made. They're much more labor intensive. The materials are more expensive, et cetera, et cetera. So this lists here in the United States for $450. I bought mine, and I did buy it with my own funds for $360. So it's a nice, for a celluloid pen with a soft gold nib, or even just any gold nib, it's not a bad price. You're not going to find a lot of celluloid pens for this particular price range. Is it worth it over the, you know, the injection molded Platinum 3776, which you can get from U.S. retailers? It retails for around $170. You can get it from Japanese retailers, gray market, for less than that. Is it worth the difference? If your only consideration is writing, is the writing performance? No, I don't think it is. If you like the aesthetics and the materials of this more, then yeah, I think it's worth it. You're going to get a great writer no matter what. So anyway, all right, that is my short overview of the Platinum 3776 Jade Celluloid. This is the fourth video in a row I've recorded, so I'm getting a little tongue-tied here. Great pen. Really like it. Find myself using it quite a bit. I love the soft fine nib. It is finer than I normally like my nibs to be. I would like a slightly larger tip. If Platinum made a soft medium readily available, I would snap that up in a hot second. Nakaya, which uses nibs made by Platinum, has a soft medium available, and I've used one, and they're glorious pens, glorious nibs. I really like those. For some reason, Platinum has not made the soft mediums available on the Platinum brand. Hopefully they will at some point. And if they do, I will be one of the first in line to get one. So anyway, thank you again for watching, and we will see you here next time on The Pen Habit. Take care. Bye.